Welcome to this quick tutorial. Today, you will learn how to use Microsoft PowerPoint to build, customize, and share engaging presentations in less than 20 minutes. Okay, let's get started with PowerPoint. Click Start. The Start button is here. Type the word PowerPoint. The program appears here. Click on it. PowerPoint launches. And now this is the home screen. At the home screen, you'll see blank presentation. You'll see recent documents. These are the PowerPoint presentation documents that you recently worked on. So you can find them here and click on it if you want to open it or to work on it again. On the side here, you can see a gallery of themes. If you want to see more of those themes, then you can click more themes. When you click on it, the themes are all displayed here, so you can choose one which you want. In this tutorial, we will create a blank presentation. Let's say we are making a slideshow about Mount St. Mary's College, Namagunga. So I will click blank presentation. It will launch with one slide here. You'll observe that on the side here, I have a thumbnail slide labeled 1. It is highlighted with a red background. So the one which is highlighted with a red background is the one which is open here. And when I click to type anything here, it will be going to the first slide. So in the first slide, I want to type Mount St. Mary's College, Namagunga. Here I want to add the subtitle as Quality Education to the Girl Child. You can see that is what I have in my first slide. I can click there again, click at the beginning, I press enter to move this vision just below. Now that is how my presentation looks like. It has one slide talking about Mount St. Mary's College Namagunga as a school that offers quality education to the girl child. Now I have one slide and yet I need more slides. What do I do? That means I must add more slides to this presentation. But before you go ahead, it is a good practice to save your work right away from here so that you have your work on your computer. So, how do we do it? To save your work, click this file, Save As, because you are saving for the first time. Then you'll come here to Browse. Find the location where you want to save your work. For now, you want to save it to the desktop for quick access. So click desktop. Save the file as Mount St. Mary's College Namagunga. I'm saving it as a short form. Then click save. Your presentation has been saved. You can check up here on the top left this side. You are going to see the name of the presentation. To add a new slide, you will click home, then new slide. Okay, it displays the different layouts for those slides. Now, slide layout determines how your slide is going to look like when you type text in the text boxes. It's just the arrangement of the text boxes in the slide. You can see the boxes, how they are arranged here. This is the very first one, this one which we used. It's called the title slide. Now, title and content means you're going to type the title and then outline bullet points in that title. We have the section header, to content, comparison, title only, blank, content with caption, and picture with caption. It will be upon you to choose what you want. For now, let's use the title and content. Okay, once I click on it, it opens a new slide. At first I had one slide. I think you can see that I have the second slide introduced into my presentation. In this slide, I want to type something about the school, and that is the background. Background 1. What characterizes the background of Mount St. Mary's College Namagunga? It's a girls' school for all level, for O and A levels. Press enter. Then you enter the next fact about the background. It was founded in 1942. By my mother, Kevin. Press enter. Started with only 12 students. Okay, press enter. It was officially opened in 1946 with 65 students as the first girls' school in Uganda. Okay. I have my slide here now. See? Okay, I have a slide that is second in this presentation. What do I do next? Can you now be able to add a slide? Yes, you can be able to add a slide into this presentation. So next is, how do I open an existing presentation, a presentation which you prepared earlier on and now you want to open it and work on it. Just simply come to File, then click Open, then you browse. Find the document where you saved it. You will still see the most recent ones you worked on here, but if it is not very recent, you'll have to click on Browse. Okay, yeah, these are on the desktop. Yes, I can, maybe it is on the desktop and it's called Presentation Software Lesson 1. Click on the file you want to edit or to modify and then you click Open. Okay, yes, you see, that is the presentation I want to work on. Maybe to add more slides, maybe I want to delete. So now I'm going to use this various presentation to show you how you can delete slides. I want to delete all these empty slides. These are the ones I've been calling thumbnail slides. You can see them on the left pane here. I want to delete all these ones which don't contain any content. You realize that when I click, what is displayed in the center here is the one which is highlighted. So if I want this one, I click on it. But I want those ones to remain. So I come here, right click. You'll see different options. You can add a new slide after that. You can duplicate that slide. You can delete the slide. So you have so many actions that you can do just by right clicking on the slide. Me, I want to delete. So delete slide. I right click this one also. Delete slide. I right click. Delete slide. So you see that I'm now left with only two slides in my presentation I have edited. Yes, so click save. Save the changes that you have done to your presentation. You can close it if you are sure those are the only changes that you wanted. So you see, I was able to open an existing presentation file and then I edited it. You can hide or you can delete a slide. Okay, so I want to add a slide between Mount St. Mary's, between the first slide and then the second slide. Just click on the first slide, right click. You can see new slide is there. So when I click new slide, a slide is added in the middle here. You can see there is a blank slide, but it is added in the middle. I want to delete it. Right click, delete. Now, sometimes you may just simply want to right click here and then you add a new slide. Right click just in this space here, add a slide, new slide. You can do the same here. If you want it between the two slides, then you'll click between the two slides and click new slide. There we are. Okay. Yes, I think you noticed that. All right. You can also duplicate the slide. For example, I want a fourth slide, but the fourth slide should be identical to the third slide. I right click and then I say duplicate slide. You see, slide number 3 and slide number 4 are containing exactly the same data. They are very identical. So I duplicated the slide. Okay, let me now delete this. Okay, delete. So you can keep on playing around with the right click, which launches different options that you can work with to modify or to change the looks of your slides. All right, now let's look at something else, and that is formatting text and slides. How do you format the text? When we say formatting text in a slide, we are now referring to the changing of the appearance of the text in that slide. An example, you may want to change the font size. You may want to change the font color, you know? So it is a matter of highlight the text which you want to format. For example, I want the name of the school to appear in red. So highlight, click home. Okay. On the home, you have this section which is the font group. In the font group, you can change the font color. You can change the font to whatever you want. Let me change it to Algerian for proper visibility. You can change the size. It's at size 60. You can put it at 66. Okay, there we are. You can change the color. So the first step is to simply highlight the text and then you'll be able to handle all this. You can make it bold, you can italicize, you can underline all this. You can just find them around the font group. If you don't want to keep on using this, you can click this arrow. Follow the cursor. Okay, there is an arrow here. And this arrow is usually called the font launcher. So it launches the font dialog box. You can see it here. So it is telling me the changes I had made. I changed to Algerian. I made it bold. The size was 66. The color was red. I can change the underline style. I can strike through, okay, double strike through. All these I can do, okay, I can superscript, I can make subscript, and so on, okay? So you can make changes to the font or to the text in that way. You could also want to align text, for example, left, center. Okay, Algerian is not looking good. So let me change from Algerian to any other font. Okay, let me use this. Okay, so you may want to change the alignment. For example, let me now use this one. You may want to adjust the alignment to left or center. So in such a case, you're going to highlight the text. Up here, you have the paragraph group, which you can use. Paragraph group, you can launch the paragraph dialog box here by clicking this, or you can change directly from here. For now, let me change directly from here. See, that is center, that is left, and that is justified. So you can keep it left aligned. So you can change the alignment like that. You can toggle between the options in the paragraph group here to change the numbering styles. For example, you can change the bullets to look different. Okay, that is it. Or you can even change them to numbers. You see, when I click here, I can use numbers to outline my points in the slide. But for now, well, I love to use the circular ones, so I leave them there. But if you want to change, please change. Okay, now we have these slides. This is the first slide. This is the second slide. If you want to change the positions of this slide, so that the second one, okay, let me create the third slide so that we use it to move the text the way we want. Okay, click here, and then I want to add another title and content here. Okay, so these are objectives: educate and emancipate young girls, sensitize and raise the status of women and girls through education, give leadership training. So I have these two slides. Objectives is slide number 2. Background is slide number 3. So I may want background to be slide number 2. But yet I had already typed like this. Just come here to the third slide and then press and hold the left button of your mouse. Move until you reach the position you want. So I have managed to exchange to move background to position number 2. You can also move this slide from here to position number 3. So simply press and hold the left button of the mouse and move to the position where you want. I think you can see that I'm able to move move the slides up and down like that. So that's how you can move slides from one position to another. Now, can we advance a bit? We want to insert tables and charts in this presentation of ours. So the first thing is, let's create a new slide here. Maybe right click and then new slide. I want a new slide. Okay, let me start with inserting a table. Simply, let's say table of performance across years. So click, and then I want the table. You can see that the tables are here. You can choose from here, insert table, or you can click here on insert here, and then you say table, insert table, choose the number of rows. Maybe you want 3 rows, and then you want 5 columns, 3 columns and then 5 rows. Okay, so I now have the table. Now it is my role to simply type in the data. Maybe since 20, 25, since 20, 24, since 20, 23. So you can enter your data in the table in this section. What next? You can change the design of this presentation by clicking on design here, and then you choose the design of your choice. These are so many designs. Each time you point, PowerPoint will give you a preview of how that design looks like. You see, this one looks like that. That one's different like that. If you want to view all the designs in the presentation, all my designs are available here. They are here. I can, when I click that arrow, I can view all of them here. But if I find that the one I want is available here just without me having to display all, then I just click on it and it will be applied. Okay, so for now, I'm going to use this kind of design. Please try to test your designs. Try to test as many designs as possible. Okay, so you see that my presentation is taking shape in that format. You can also insert a picture. For example, I want to use choose the badge of the school to appear here. I'll click insert pictures. I want a picture from this device, so I'll click this device. If you are using lower versions of Office than 2021, it may skip that part of selecting this device and brings you here straight. So I have a logo on the desktop. I just move around here, move the slide bar. I have it on the desktop. I look for the badge. It is here. Good. I have it here, and then insert it. Yes, there we are. It came like that. These are the handles you can use. You can use these handles to increase the size of the badge or to reduce the size of the badge. You do that by left click, bring your pointer here to the corner, changes shape, press and hold the left button of the mouse, and then move upward. There you are increasing. When you move downward, you're reducing. Okay, I want that to be the size of my badge. So I want to move it to a position that I want. So I will move it to the center here, press and hold the left button of the mouse, and move the badge to the position I want it to be. I want it there. So yes, I have put the badge or the logo in my presentation. Okay, that's how we resize. We also have shapes. You can insert the shapes. Like click insert the shapes. We have them here. The arrows, the circles. We shall look at these ones action buttons later. But for now, let's put just ordinary shapes. Let's use the rectangle. When I click on the rectangle, you see how the pointer looks like. It is a plus. That means it is ready to draw something. Press and hold the left button of the mouse, then move wherever you want. So you can move this shape the way you want to wherever you want. I've moved the shape there. You can play with the shape. You can resize by left click. Bring the pointer to the corner. It can be left, it can be right, wherever you want. Press and hold the left button of your mouse, then move. There you are expanding the box. When you move down, you're reducing the size of the box. When you come to the center, press and hold the left button of your mouse, move. You're moving the shape from one place to another. That is it. Next, you can add transitions. You can add animations. Transitions are movement of the slides possess as they move from one slide to another. That is transition. Animations are usually applied to the text. How does the text come in, or how does the text go out of the slide? So I can click here and then I put flying. You see, that is flying. Okay, I can. The animation is applied to the object which is clicked. For example, I have now clicked this box. The animation is going to go to this box only. Let me use floating. That is it. Let me apply swipe. Yes, swipe for the badge. That is how we apply animations. That's how we apply with transitions. You're going to click and then choose the transition which you want. For example, let me see this. Move things on previous slide to their new locations on the current slide. To get the best results, duplicate the slide. Move things around, apply. So just keep on pointing to the transition, and it will explain to you how that transition works. Let me use reveal. After selecting the transition, click apply to all. If you want to learn more in PowerPoint, please like this video, subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that each time I release such a video, you will be the first one to be notified. Let's meet in the next one.